Picture the poet who strives to feast your eyes with words. Picture the poet who uses ink to paint each verse. Picture the poet who wants to draw sounds into your ears. Picture the poet who laughs at her photographs, who prefers landscapes to portraits.
A lot of the kind of high profile events, whether that's spoken word events or whatever it is, tend to focus in London. So it's brilliant that it comes out and about to, you know, where everybody is, to other places as well, and gets people involved that, you know, don't travel or wouldn't know about it, and it makes it real and values the place.
So let me say this ordinarily. I have autism, but there is so much more to me. Thank you.
So we've got, as I say, a variety of performers from a variety of places, but we've got a definite local flavour in our evening. Our next performer is from one of the local schools. We've been having some workshops in the area. And Tanisha is going to come on and she's going to do some performances of pieces that she's written.
Nice, because I don't usually perform in front of a lot of people. I usually do it in my bedroom, so it's nice to feel like people like my music.
The first fish I make is rubbish. It has no gills, it has no fins, it looks like a wet sock full of sand, and what's more, it can't swim. When I throw it in, it just sinks. Yes, the first fish I make sticks. The second is a lich. I managed to get a funky kind of tail, something that narrowly fails to be a fin. When I throw it in, it stops, thinks, then flaps out of my fin and sinks. The third fish has eyes as big as clams. The fourth likes a pointer inside. The fifth fish has fins that look like hands. The sixth mysteriously darts. The seventh, eighth, and ninth fishes all look at me accusingly as they float upside down. The tenth makes a sound like a fart, then falls apart in an awful pinkish cloud.
It was really tremendous. I mean, the whole setting I like, the pictures around of the different poets You know, and a number of them I know and have read. I've read the works of some of them, and then to see the live poetry too and the music. It was really very exciting, actually.
So I'm a guillemot. 1, 2, 3. Let's try that. I'm a guillemot. Yes, an internal count. I am a guillemot. I know the drill a lot. I use my bill a lot. I get the fish out of the wet, so I eat my fill a lot. I live on ledges, vertical edges. Eating while I do not know.
Really enjoyable and unusual event in Lincoln, and we just can't quite believe that it's all been put on for free.
The folk on the walls, they didn't seem to be offended in any way by what went on. In fact, I could almost hear the applause from the walls.
I paddle in a tugboat between cultures, wanting to wear traditional clothing, swapping fear for fact, my skin became the canvas of the ancestors. Why try to differentiate between Gaelic and Patois? I make no distinction.
Leathery-faced thought of loved ones.